What up, Giants fans, Hub watchers, YouTube subscribers, Twitter and Instagram followers? It's your boy Noname back at it again with another Giants update video. This time an update on the Deandre Baker situation. So, I mean, before I get into it, I'd like to encourage you all to smash that like button, hit that subscribe button. If you haven't already done so, turn on post notifications, you know, share it out, all that. I hope you guys are staying safe, washing your hands, wearing your masks where needed and all that. And real quick, if you guys want me to do another just chilling stream tonight, let me know and I'll get it up. I'm down for that. It literally just popped into my mind before I started recording. But I will say I'll be doing them Tuesday night and Friday night. It's going to be either Friday or Thursday night. I'm going to do another one of those streams because then those are days I'm taking my final. So kind of keeping in with the theme of I did one after my last final. Going to hop on, play Halo with you guys again on those days. But if you want one tonight, let me know. So let's get into it. Deandre Baker, who turned himself into the police on Saturday morning, has been released from jail on $200,000 bail. So the $200,000 bail comes at $25,000 for each charge that he got. So he had four charges of aggravated assault and four charges of armed robbery. Now, like in my previous video, where I said we shouldn't jump to conclusions, you know, we shouldn't kill the guy just yet, I said I find it a weird coincidence that all these things regarding Baker's character are coming out now at a time that he's being accused of these charges. And once again, I'm not on either side of the situation. I'm not on the side that he's guilty. I'm not on the side that he's innocent. I'm just like, let's wait and see what happens. Because I find it a very weird coincidence that all of a sudden, while he's being accused, we're getting reports of, oh, he's been missing team meetings. He hasn't been a good teammate. Although that one, him being a good teammate, has been in question for a while now. And you know things that basically like defamation of character the past couple of days while he's been accused of these things. And I'm gonna come across something in these articles. I'm not even sure if I said it. Just like last time also, I got two articles pulled up, one from ESPN, one from The Post. The same two sources I went to the last time. I trust these guys more so than most of the other websites that I've been reading from. And you know, coming across it, one of them says that he's actually been in team meetings. I have right here in the ESPN article, and I'll throw it up. It says Baker had been participating in most of the voluntary virtual off-season meetings and activities that began in late April, a source told ESPN. Now, of course, with everything and sources and whatnot, you know, a source could be anybody. But I will say, it's conflicting stories from both sides. We got reports saying that he hasn't been at any meetings. We have reports saying that he's been to most meetings. We got reports saying that he's been to half. Nobody knows. That's kind of the thing that I'm trying to tell you guys here, right? Nobody knows the exact situation, so I feel like we should withhold judgment. Maybe he hasn't actually been to any meetings and this is somebody from Baker's party trying to, you know, lighten up the situation on his end. Or maybe he has actually been to team meetings and this is the Giants letting people know, hey, we've been working with him throughout the offseason, and this is as much a surprise as it is to us as it is to you guys, the fans and the media and everything. So let me get back into the articles real quick. $25,000 for each charge. Of course, him and Quentin Dunbar, they were accused of stealing, and I can't pronounce the brands of these watches, but you know, a $18,000 Rolex, a $25,000 Hublot, which funnily enough is actually like the official watch of the Giants, so that's pretty ironic. A $17,500 Audemars Piguet, I have no idea if I'm pronounced that right, along with other things from a house party in Florida that they were attending. And of course, they should not have been there in the first place because of lockdown. But as I pointed out in the last video, Baker's lawyer says that he has evidence in favor of Baker, sworn statements, affidavit, as I've been told is pronounced by a couple of the guys in the comment section. Thank you guys for that. Learning something new every day. I'm just going to call it sworn statements because that's essentially what it means. And one of them said, from Dominic Johnson, a friend of both Baker and Dunbar, he said that an argument broke out between them when they were playing dice. And the official statement is, I was never in fear for my life in any situation that happened that day. And Deandre Baker did not take any property from me and did not point a gun at anyone. Dunbar's lawyer, Michael Grieco, presented five of these sworn statements from the same five parties as Baker's lawyer did. And they all are basically backing up Baker's side of the story. They're all saying, hey man, it was an argument. Maybe it was blown out of proportion. There was no pulling of any firearms or anybody. There was no stealing of any property on anybody. Going back to the last video, I said it could very well be that somebody just had bad blood out for Deandre, jealousy or whatever you wanted to say, for these two NFL players that came in, they were playing dice, and maybe they wanted to get more money out of them. So, you know, maybe they went to the police. It could be a case of blackmail. It could be a case of just trying to get back at Deandre. It could be a case of a mix-up. It could be a case where he's not involved at all, like with the Janoris Jenkins situation last year. It could be all of those, but it could also very well be that Deandre pulled the gun on the dude and stole his watches and he made a dumb, stupid decision. I just don't know yet. And every day, you know, more and more evidence comes out. We'll see how the case plays out. As of right now, of course, Deandre and Dunbar have been requested to not have any contact with the victims or anybody else with the case. You know, when I heard that, for some reason, I thought of Antonio Brown, because Antonio Brown was asked the same thing when he was going through his legal troubles last season. And of course, Brown made the stupid decision of contacting the victim right away after he was told not to when he got released by the Patriots. Now, I hope that Deandre doesn't do that, because I do want him to be innocent, not only as a Giants fan so that we have our cornerback back, but I want him to be innocent because he's still a young guy. You know, he still has a whole life ahead of him. If he actually did this and, you know, he made this decision, he threw away his life, he's going to be in jail for like, what, 10, 15 years at the minimum. His life is essentially over. So I do want him to be innocent. I'm going to say that. I don't know if he is, but I do want him to be. And so he's been requested that, but the Giants have also requested that Baker not attend any of the virtual meetings so that Baker could focus on his legal troubles and get that sorted out. I see this as a good sign in terms of him being back on the team, because I feel like if they didn't want him back on the team, they would just straight up release him or maybe suspend him from team activities and whatnot. But they are saying, you know, basically take this time, focus on getting, you know, your stuff sorted out. If you are guilty, we're going to cut you. You're probably going to be on a way shorter lease now. But, you know, they're giving him time to focus on that. And this is a benefit for both Deandre and for the team, because he comes into the virtual meetings. All the players are going to be thinking about it. They might not be talking about it outright, but their minds are going to be distracted. They're going to be thinking about, hey, man, what's going on? They're probably going to try and talk to Deandre about the case, which I'm sure he's not allowed to do and all that. It's going to be a big distraction for the team. It already is a distraction as they're having their meetings right now, I'm sure. So it would be worse if he steps in there. The smart thing to do is to let him take care of it on the side. Even if he is innocent, though, it's going to have a big impact because he's missing vital time. The time is already cut short because of the pandemic, because teams are not able to meet in person. You know, it's already difficult enough. They have to meet over computer. Now you cut that down, him having to learn a new system, you know, because there's a new defensive coach, there's a new defensive scheme. Him having to get acclimated with his new coaches and with the new head coach. Him having to get to know the new people in the cornerback room, because they added a lot of new people in the cornerback room, specifically a James Bradbury, who would have been his mentor this year and would have had a lot of things to taught Deandre. He's missing out on vital time. And even if he is innocent, depending on how long this investigation in this case goes, he still might not see the field come week one. You know, he's going to need time to adjust, learn the playbook, and all of that. But that's what I got for y'all today. Oh yeah, and this, yeah, he was asked to turn in his carry permit and his gun upon release, which of course makes sense. I'm sure he does have a gun and maybe, you know, a concealing carry or maybe just a regular carry permit. And as somebody that's being accused of what you're being accused of course the police would ask that you turn that in. He did so. That's really the only other tidbit there is. If you guys want to read these articles, I'm going to leave the links down in the description below, because they talk about a lot more regarding the case. They talk about, you know, kind of like framing the situation with the evidence they already had of what happened, you know, the possibilities, you know, possible consequences of if he's guilty and all that. I'll leave the links to the articles down below. But this is really the latest on the Deandre Baker situation. I'm still on the fence saying there's still not enough evidence for us to make any type of judgment. I'm gonna wait for it to come out. I feel like if he was really as guilty as some, you know, media is making it sound, then I think the Giants would have already cut him, because they've been in constant contact with him and his lawyers. Of course, this could just be his lawyers playing a really good game and putting on a really good face of him being innocent, but we don't know. Let me know what you guys think. Put your comments down below, and I'm out. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Put your comments down below. Make sure you smash that like button, subscribe, and turn on post notifications. Until next time, I'm out. Yer.